call on Mrs. Barber and Mr. Skelly to bring forward Mrs. Christian.
I, Claire Sarah Beverly Christian, do swear by Almighty God that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and her heirs and successors.
Her Majesty's counsel, your fellows and your own, you shall not reveal. You shall use your best endeavours to maintain the ancient laws and customs of this isle. You shall justly and truly deliver your opinion and do right in all matters which shall be put unto you without favour or affection, affinity or consanguinity, love or fear, reward or gain, or for any hope thereof. But in all things you shall deal uprightly and justly and do wrong to no man. So help you God and by the contents of this book. I invite you now to sign the Liber Juramentorum. If you could just sign that.
Oops, sorry.
Mr. Speaker, I confirm that the oaths have been taken by and administered to Mrs. Christian.
Lord, I have the honour and pleasure to present Claire Sarah Beverly Christian, new member for Douglas South.
Thank you. Mrs. Christian, may I have your certificate of election? Thank you very much. Thank you. It's my pleasure to welcome you to the House and present you with a copy of our standing orders, our rules of procedure. I now invite you to sign the record of standing orders and the code of conduct for members at the Secretary's desk. Congratulations. Your sponsors will now escort you to your seat in the House. Call on Mrs. Corlett and Mr. Thomas to bring forward Mr. Quine.
I, Stephen Paul Quine, do swear by Almighty God that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heirs and successors. Help me God.
Her Majesty's counsel, your fellows and your own, you shall not reveal. You shall use your best endeavours to maintain the ancient laws and customs of this isle. You shall justly and truly deliver your opinion and do right in all matters which shall be put unto you without favour or affection, affinity or consanguinity, love or fear, reward or gain, or for any hope thereof. But in all things you shall deal uprightly and justly, and do wrong to no man. So help you God, and by the contents of this book. I could invite you to sign the legal journal, please. Just sign that as well. Mr. Speaker, I confirm that the oaths have been taken by and administered to Mr. Quine. Thank you.
Mr. Quine, may I have your certificate of election? Sorry.
I have the pleasure and the honour to present to you, Mr. Speaker, Stephen Paul Quine.
Thank you very much. Thank you. It's my pleasure to welcome you to the House and present you with a copy of our standing orders, our rules of procedure. I now invite you to sign the record of standing orders and the code of conduct for members at the Secretary's desk. Your sponsors will now escort you to your seat in the House. Honourable members, it's my great pleasure to welcome on your behalf Mrs. Christian and Mr. Quine as members of this ancient and honourable House. Ancient it no doubt is, as forming part of the world's oldest continuous parliament, dating back to the 10th century, and the book that those members have just signed, the Liber Juramentorum, or Book of Oaths, dates back to the early part of the 15th century. It bears the names of all the members of this House for whom there are records back to that time. But I am sure I do not need to remind you of the big shoes you are filling in recent history. We remember with great fondness the work, drive and commitment of your predecessors in those seats. But from the zeal and drive we have so far seen, I am sure there can be little doubt that you will promote the interests of the people of Douglas South and our island with the same energy. I also mention this Honourable House, and I encourage you to act as parliamentarians, to work in a dignified, if robust and challenging way, to pursue the matters in your manifesto and the causes that you promote. You join us at a time of frenetic activity. It's an exciting and challenging time to be in Manx politics, a challenge I have no doubt you will rise to. May I, on your behalf and on behalf of the House, thank His Honour the First Deemster and the Chief Registrar for their attendance this morning. And can I ask the Secretary to escort them from the House?